This is one of my favorite keyboards. This is the Satechi SM1 Slim Mechanical Backlit Bluetooth Keyboard. It's hard to say, but it is in a really good spot between expensive full-featured keyboards and those inexpensive portable keyboards that always look like they're going to be good, but then don't really work very well. This is a really solid keyboard that works with almost every device. It can be switched between Windows and Macs really easily with the push of some buttons. It comes with extra keycaps, so you can swap the keys between the Mac and the Windows modes. I've been using it for general typing, where it feels really great, but I also use it for video editing and occasional gaming because the keys feel really solid, and those solid keys are really great when you're doing video editing. The keys use these low profile switches, so you get the nice sort of tactile feedback without like too loud of a clicky noise. I mean, it's loud because it's a mechanical keyboard, right? It's not really that loud. It comes in both a black or a white. This is more kind of gray than white, but I picked up the white one because it goes better with my Mac, but the black one shows us backlighting better, and I'm going to talk about backlighting in a second. This keyboard works with both Mac and Windows, and they include extra keys so you can swap out the keycaps if you're going to use Mac. To switch keycaps, all you have to do is just pop them off, and you pop the Mac keys back into place, and you're good to go. So you can connect via a cable, via Bluetooth, which is how I'm using it, or with one of these 2.4 gigahertz dongles you put in the USB port. It has this backlighting, which you can shut off if you want. It's got 14 different patterns for the backlighting, which is a little bit gimmicky, but sometimes I like to have it go through the different patterns. I found that the battery lasts like forever. I've gone several weeks without charging it when the backlight's off, like when I'm on the road, and even with the backlight on, it's lasting me like hours and hours and hours with the backlight on. Cleaning it is really super easy too, since the keycaps pop right off. If you want to clean something, you pop off the key, you can blow the dirt out from underneath it. The keys wipe off pretty nicely too. I just use one of those alcohol pads to keep it clean. The one downside to this is the same downside with every 75% keyboard, which is that you're missing some of the keys, right? But this isn't as much of a problem on the SM1 because it's got the page up, page down, home and end keys here, and the T key, the arrow key, is over here. So the only thing you're really missing is the number pad, which for me isn't a big deal because I barely do like spreadsheets or any other number crunching that would benefit from that keypad. You probably want to hold onto the instruction manual because most of the settings on the keyboard are done using a couple different keystrokes. I'm never going to remember them. So like resetting the keyboard is function, left control key, and the forward delete button. I'm never going to remember that. So either hold on to this or just take a picture of it and leave it in your photo album. So the bottom line is I think that this keyboard is great. It's practical. It's not terribly expensive. It looks really good and it works with all of my devices. So if you're looking to upgrade your desktop setup and you want a mechanical keyboard that's not too loud, it's not too expensive, and it's not too complicated, but it works really, really well, this is the one for you. I will have links to this keyboard in the description below. Leave me a comment if you're using one of these keyboards or one of the other keyboards from Satechi and let me know what you think about that. If you have any other keyboards you think I should look at, leave that in the comments as well. For Dave Tries This, I'm David Schloss, and as always, thanks so much for giving this a try.